Welcome to CSIRO Vod. I'm Glenn Paul. I'm at Mogo on the New South Wales south coast at a bushfire testing facility where a purpose-built house behind me is about to undergo a trial by fire by CSIRO scientists to establish whether it's fire resistant, with the hope that it could pave the way to a new generation of bushfire resistant homes for areas prone to bushfire that could potentially save lives. The test house was built using fairly conventional construction techniques such as a steel frame and cladding, cellulose cement in flooring and lining details, and fiberglass insulation in the walls, floor and ceiling to act as a flame barrier to protect the habitable space inside. The house was set up on an adjacent gas burner test bed, kind of like an oversized barbecue, so the flames, with the wind blowing from behind, would engulf the house in a blaze of fury, much like a real bushfire front. Inside the house, I was kind of expecting to see a family of circa 1950 atomic test style plastic dummies. But of course, in the 21st century, sensors and video cameras can provide far more reliable data.
Even if it fails, we'll know exactly how much it failed by and be able to then advise on how we can slightly modify the design to perform adequately.
And how confident are you with the house? Would you be willing to stand inside it while it burns?
I'd be more confident to stand in this house compared to many other conventional designs out there, but I'll have a much clearer understanding after the end of this test.
Australia has been devastated by bushfire many times, so to have a house that might stand up to bushfires would obviously attract a lot of attention from the media. News crews flew in, and a film crew from ABC TV's leading science program, Catalyst, were on hand to record the story. So as the countdown began to the big burn, scientists added an extra element of realism by putting leaf litter into the gutters and around the doors. Well, we're not far away from burning down the house. We've just been waiting for the right weather conditions for the wind to pick up. The more wind, the easier that house is going to burn. The Bureau of Meteorology had forecast ideal conditions for the burn that afternoon, and as conditions picked up, Justin made the announcement.
We'll have final briefing and then start getting in our places for a 2:30 test start.
So a final briefing on what we could expect, then it was back out to take up positions in the designated safe zones. It was from there that two brave souls ventured out and lit the fire. The plan was to burn in stages, with the fire slowly building up to the stuff of nightmares. The control room was a hive of activity, and Justin took a brief moment to explain what was going on.
We're a little past two-thirds of the way through the radiation profile. So we've moved through the sort of the gradual build-up phase, and we're starting to get into the steeper part of the curve where there'll be a fairly rapid ramp-up of the intensity that the house receives before the full flame immersion. 30 seconds. Five, four, three, two, one, go.
Even standing back in the safe zone, the heat was extreme, and I was sure the house would disintegrate. The blast went on for quite some time, more than the duration of a normal bushfire front. Finally, the test was over, and with the gas now off, the house was left smouldering, but still standing.
We've lost the tube.
From here, everyone was very keen to see what the inside of the house looked like. Overall, it seemed pretty good. Everything was intact, and there was no sign of fire damage. But just how hot it got in there, I wasn't able to tell at a glance without those melted plastic dummies. But CSIRO scientists were soon plugging in their laptops and downloading data for analysis. Well, it's looking a little worse for wear, but the house is still standing. Whether it would be survivable if you'd been inside it, we won't know until Justin and the team have a look at the data. If you'd like to find out more about the bushfire house, check out our website at www.csiro.au.